Hi students. Okay, in the last video we have completed types of matrices and up to transpose of matrices with the properties, right? Now, so continuation of that matrices topic. So take one note. Suppose if you take one matrix. Now this video onwards, entrance part will start more. If A equal to 2, 0, 0, 3 and B equal to 1, 0, 0, 0, 5, 0, 0, 0, 10 or 8. So these two are examples of diagonal matrix, right? So simply you can write it as diagonal of 2 comma 3 and this can be written as B equal to diagonal of 1, 5, 8 like this. Okay. Now if you multiply suppose A equal to 2, 3 and one more B I will take. So this one you take as C and one more matrix also 2 by 2 matrix if you take that is 4, 0, 0, 5. This is also diagonal matrix of order 2. Suppose if you multiply these two A into B, multiply here. So this can be written as a diagonal of 4, 5. Okay. Now multiply these two AB equal to. So this is 2, 0, 0, 3 and this has 4, 0, 0, 5. Now multiply these two. If you multiply first row with first column 2 into 4 and first row with second column 0, first row with first column, second row with first column 0 and second row with second column 3 into 5. Right? By this example, you can generalize this one. So here, suppose A equal to diagonal of A1, A2, A3, etc. An means A be the diagonal matrix of order N, right? So like this, A be the diagonal matrix of order n. How to write this is A1 0 0 0 0 like this, 0 A2 0 0 like this, right? So this is the diagonal matrix of order n and B also one more diagonal matrix of order same order, that is B1 B2 B3 etc. Bn if you take. So if you multiply these two A into B, if you multiply, so here I will write, this is the important point for the entrance purpose, especially for KSET. So you will get like this, diagonal of A1, B1, comma A2, B2, A3, B3, etc., An, Bn, like this you will get, okay. For example, one more example you take. Suppose A equal to 100200003 and B equal to one more matrix 400050006. If these two, if you multiply according to this formula, so how to get that is equal to A into B if you multiply 1 into 4 like this you will get. So simply this one, then AB equal to asking means directly you can write 1 into 4, 0, 0, 0, 2 into 5, 0, 0, 0, 3 into 6 like this you will get. Nothing but first row with first column, first row with second column, first row with third column. First row with first column means 4 only you will get. First row with second column means 0. First row with third column also 0. Like that, second row with second column here 2 into 5. Third row with the third column means 3 into 6, remaining 0 you will get, right? 4, 10, 18 diagonal elements by this formula, right? You can conclude like this. Next, this is the note 1. And one more note. So before to that, I will give example. So if you take one example, you will get the clarity. Suppose A equal to 2003, right? So this can be written as diagonal of 2 comma 3, right? Simply you can write diagonal of 2 comma 3. Diagonal of 2 comma 3 means these are the diagonal elements remaining 0, means diagonal matrix. And diagonal elements are 2 comma 3, means order 2 comma 2 means. And now, if you take A square, what you will get is 2003 and 2003. Multiply these two. How to get? That is equal to first row with the first column. 2 into 2, 2 square. So here, next to 0, 0, here 0. Second row with first column 0. And this one 3 square. Okay? Means, what you are observing here? So if you multiply A square, so A is a diagonal matrix, and multiplying A square, then 2 square, here 3 square getting. So how to conclude this one? So generalized formula is that is equal to A equal to, suppose this is the diagonal matrix of order n, A equal to, that is suppose D1, D2, D3, etc. Dn is there. So if you take A power n, n is a non-negative, so n is a suppose positive integer, if you take diagonal of, how to get diagonal of D power n, D2 power n, D3 power n, etc. Dn power n, like this. So you take one more example. Suppose like this is there, A equal to 400050006 is there. Suppose A cube asking. A square asking means what you will get? 4 square 0005 square 0006 square you will get. A cube means 4 cube, 5 cube, 6 cube. A to the power of 4, yeah, power 4, power 4, power 4, like this. So this is our important formula. Right? Right. Next, these are the two notes important for the KSET. Next, definition, symmetric matrix. And skew symmetric matrix. Symmetric and skew symmetric matrix. So symmetric matrix means a square matrix A is said to be the symmetric if A transpose equal to A. A square matrix A is said to be the symmetric if A transpose equal to A. Skew symmetric matrix means a square matrix A is said to be the skew symmetric if A transpose equal to minus. In the last video, transpose and the properties of transpose we have completed. Right? And now symmetric means if A transpose equal to A, then symmetric. Skew symmetric means A transpose equal to minus A, skew symmetric. Definitely by on symmetric and skew symmetric, one problem will be there. No? So listen carefully because properties are important. The definition is very easy. A transpose equal to A transpose equal to minus A. So one example you take. Suppose A equal to 4, 5 and here 6. This is A. A transpose means interchanging the rows and columns. Already we learned that one. So interchanging the row and columns. First row becomes first column. Second row becomes second column here. So 4, 5, 5, 6. Right? First column becomes first row. Second column becomes second row. So 4, 5, 5, 6. A transpose equal to A. So this is a symmetric matrix. Skew symmetric matrix A equal to 0, 2, minus 2, 0, 0, 2, minus 2, 0. So A equal to 0, 2, minus 2, 0. So A transpose, if you take A transpose equal to rows changes to columns, column changes to rows, means 0 minus 2, 2, 0. First column becomes first row, second column becomes second row. So 0 minus 2 minus 2, 0. But here, if you take, this is not equal to A, just you take minus common or multiply with minus, what you will get? So here 0 you will get, here 2, here minus 2, here 0. You have to take minus common, what you will get? 0 here, 2 here, minus 2 here, 0. Otherwise multiply with minus, that's it, both are 0. Now that is equal to minus 0, 2, minus 2, 0 is nothing but A only. So, A transpose equal to what? Minus A. A transpose equal to minus A. So, this is what? Skew symmetric matrix. Suppose 1, 3 by 3 matrix, if you take 0, 1, 2 and minus 1, 0, minus 4 and minus 2, 4, 0. This is also a skew symmetric matrix. Means, how to identify it is a skew symmetric matrix or not? Just to observe, definitely principal diagonal elements should be 0 in skew symmetric matrix. And here, these elements opposite sign, and these elements opposite sign, and these elements opposite sign. Here 1 means here minus 1, here 1 means here minus 1. So opposite sign, these two opposite sign, then definitely that is a skew symmetric matrix. Okay, no? Now come to properties of skew symmetric matrix. Properties of skew symmetric matrix. And symmetric and skew symmetric. Properties of symmetric and skew symmetric matrices. First one, if A is a square matrix, A is a square matrix. So what about the A plus A transpose and A transpose and A transpose A? Symmetric or skew symmetric, they will ask. So this is important concept. Listen carefully. So if A is a square matrix, any square matrix, so A plus A transpose also symmetric and A transpose also symmetric, A transpose also symmetric. Symmetric means nothing but here one matrix is there. If you take the transpose of that one, same thing getting, that is what? Symmetric. Here one matrix is there. Transpose if you take, minus of this one getting, then that is what? Skew symmetric. Now here what they are asking, A is any one of the square matrix, right? Now what they are asking, A plus A transpose is a symmetric or skew symmetric? What I am saying, yes, A plus A transpose also symmetric. So how to identify? Just you take the transpose of this one. If you get the same A plus A transpose, then that is a what? Symmetric matrix. For that, so we have transpose of the matrix properties. Once you take that A plus B whole transpose, means how to take A transpose plus B transpose. And second one, A minus B whole transpose, means how to take A transpose minus B transpose. And third one, how to take AB whole transpose, means B transpose into A transpose. Careful about this one. So by these three properties and also one more is there, KA whole transpose equal to K into A transpose, like it. So we have to find that is a symmetric or skew symmetric matrix. So they are asking A plus A transpose is symmetric or skew symmetric. How to take the transpose of this one? So treat this as A and this as B. Now it is in the form of A plus B whole transpose, sum of the two matrices. A transpose is nothing but one of the matrix. Now that is equal to, by this property, sum of the two matrices whole transpose is there, means what we have to take? First matrix transpose plus second matrix transpose. For that what we have to take? A transpose plus A transpose whole transpose we have to take. That is equal to A transpose plus A transpose whole transpose. One more property is there in transpose of the matrix. A transpose whole transpose equal to, again it is what? A only. Right? Now, See here, A transpose, O transpose, A, between what is there, some plus is there, so you can write A plus A transpose. So, A plus A transpose, whole transpose equal to what? A plus A transpose only. So, A plus A transpose is a what? So, whenever one matrix is there, whole transpose, if you take same matrix getting, then that matrix is called what? Symmetric matrix. So, that's why A plus A transpose is what? Symmetric matrix. Next, come to second one. So, here it is A transpose is what? It is also a symmetric or skew symmetric. Asking. So, what we have to take for this one also? Transpose you take. A transpose, whole transpose if you take. Same A transpose getting, then it is what? Symmetric. Minus of A transpose getting, that is skew symmetric. For that, what we have to take? This property we have to use. Here, this property AB whole transpose means multiply two matrices and transpose of that one you take, and B transpose, A transpose if you take, both are same. So that's why by this property treat this as A and this as B. Means A into B whole transpose is there. A into B whole transpose. A into B whole transpose means B transpose into A transpose. Nothing but second matrix transpose into first matrix transpose. That is what? Here, what is the second matrix? A transpose, whole transpose. What is the first matrix? A transpose. That's it. That is equal to, but already you know that A transpose, whole transpose equal to what? A. So, that's why A transpose, whole transpose is A into A transpose. Means same thing getting. So, that's why A transpose also what? Symmetric. Similarly, we can prove A transpose into A also symmetric only. Means always you have to remember, whenever A is one square matrix, A plus A transpose, A transpose, A transpose A also symmetric matrices. Okay, no? And also, next, coming to this one. Okay, these three are asymmetric. But what about this one? Whenever A is a square matrix, whenever A is a square matrix, what about A minus A transpose? Find the pulse of a concept. So, always no need to, but by heart the formulas. So, A minus A transpose is symmetric or skew symmetric asking. Nothing but, so to show it is a symmetric, it is a skew symmetric, or to show it is a symmetric, whatever it may be. So, what we have to do? To power transpose we have to take. Now, it is in the form of A minus B whole transpose. So, one matrix minus second matrix, that is equal to how to write first matrix A transpose minus second matrix whole transpose. What is the second matrix? A transpose whole transpose, that is equal to A transpose minus A transpose whole transpose is A. But is this equal to A minus A transpose? No. So, that's why what we have to take? We have to take minus common. So, then what will get? A minus A transpose. So, A minus A transpose whole transpose equal to what? Minus of A minus A transpose. So, that's why whenever one matrix transpose equal to minus of same matrix getting, means definitely this matrix is what? Skew symmetric matrix. So, that's why A minus A transpose is what? Skew symmetric matrix. So A is a square matrix means A plus A transpose and A transpose, A transpose A, symmetric matrices. Similarly, A minus A transpose is what? Skew symmetric matrix, right? Next
one is if A comma B are two symmetric matrices, A comma B are two symmetric matrices. So that is A transpose equal to A and B transpose equal to B. What are they given? A comma B are two symmetric matrices. Now what they are asking, AB plus BA is what? AB plus BA is what? Symmetric or skew symmetric? For that, what we have to do? Whole transpose we have to take. So, we know that A plus B whole transpose equal to A transpose plus B transpose, right? And now, here, A into B also one of the matrix, if you treat this as X, and BA also one of the matrix Y. So, X plus Y whole transpose is nothing but AB whole transpose plus BA whole transpose. That is equal to, again we know that AB whole transpose is nothing but B dash into A dash. So second one B dash into A dash, and here also second one A dash and first one. But here A comma B are symmetric matrices, means A transpose equal to A, B transpose equal to B. So like this we get. But between what is there here? Plus is there. So you can write AB plus BA. So AB plus BA whole transpose equal to again AB plus BA only getting, means this AB plus BA is symmetric. So like this you have to identify. Suppose same problem, A comma B are symmetric matrices given. They asking AB minus BA is what? So, symmetric or skew symmetric matrix asking. For that, what we have to do? Same thing. So, we know that AB, A minus B whole transpose equal to A transpose minus B transpose by the property of transpose. So, how to write AB whole transpose minus BA whole transpose? Again, we know that AB whole transpose equal to B transpose into A transpose. That is equal to B transpose into A transpose minus A transpose into B transpose. Right? Now, but here what are they given? A transpose equal to A. So, here BA minus AB you will get. But this is not equal to AB minus BA. So, that's why if you take minus common, AB minus BA getting. So, if you observe these two, so minus of AB minus BA getting. So, therefore, you can say AB minus BA is skew symmetric matrix. Right? Skew symmetric matrix. Whenever A comma B is symmetric matrices. Right? Like this, you have to identify. Next, suppose A is symmetric. If A is symmetric, asymmetric matrix, and N is positive integer, then what about the A power N? Symmetric or skew symmetric? We'll check. See, suppose A square is there. A is symmetric. A is symmetric means we know that A transpose equal to A. Whenever A is symmetric, A transpose equal to A. Then they asking A square is what? And A cube is what? And A to the power of 4 like this. If you take any positive integer in the power of A, means in here, A 2, 3, 4 here. So, what we can write to show A square is symmetric or skew symmetric, what we have to do? Transpose we have to take. Now, you can write this one, A transpose whole square you can write. But here given A transpose equal to A, so A square. So A square whole transpose equal to A square. So A square is symmetric whenever A is symmetric. Take A cube, same thing you will get. A to the power of 4, same thing. So A to the power of N whenever N is positive integer, same. So whenever A is symmetric and N is positive integer, then A power N is what? Symmetric. Simply they will ask the problem like this. If A is symmetric, then A power 100 is what? Symmetric. A power 2022 is what? Symmetric. So A power 2021 is what? Symmetric. Here N is any positive integer, A power N is symmetric only. Right? But same problem, if you take like this, suppose A is a skew symmetric matrix, what happens? If A is skew symmetric matrix, A is a skew symmetric matrix. So A is a skew symmetric matrix means what? A transpose equal to what? Minus A. A transpose equal to minus A. Now, what about the A square? Symmetric or skew symmetric? Well, A is a skew symmetric. So transpose you take, you can write A transpose whole square, that is equal to A transpose equal to minus A. So minus A whole square equal to A square. So A square is symmetric. A square is symmetric. But if you take A cube whole transpose, you take A transpose whole cube, but A transpose equal to minus A, that is equal to minus A whole cube, r power is there, minus A cube you will get. So that's why A cube is skew symmetric. So for this one, what we can identify, A is, so therefore A is skew symmetric. A is skew symmetric means here whenever A is skew symmetric, A square is symmetric, A cube skew symmetric, A power 4 symmetric, A power 5 skew symmetric, A power 9, suppose A power 2022 symmetric, A power 2021 skew symmetric. Means what is the conclusion from all these examples? So you can conclude like this. So power is odd positive integer, then given that odd positive integer is there means skew symmetric, even positive is there means symmetric, because even positive so avoids that negative, right? Now if A is skew symmetric, A power n is symmetric. If n is even positive integer, next, A power n is skew symmetric. Skew symmetric. If n is odd positive integer, right? Whenever A is skew symmetric, A power n is symmetric. But the previous condition is what? A is symmetric. Whatever the either even positive or odd positive, A power n is symmetric only. But whenever A is skew symmetric, so there are two cases. First one is A power n is symmetric when n is even positive integer. And second one is A power n is skew symmetric when n is odd positive integer. Right? Next. And one more condition is there, a property is there in the symmetric and skew symmetric matrices, that is every square matrix, listen carefully, every square matrix can be written as, can be expressed as sum of the symmetric and skew symmetric matrices. So repeatedly they asked based on this one problem, especially in KSET. So A equal to A plus A transpose by 2 plus A minus A transpose by 2. Every square matrix, suppose if A is a square matrix, listen carefully, if A is a, any square matrix, every square matrix can be written as sum of the symmetric and skew symmetric matrix. This is a symmetric and this is a skew symmetric matrix. Symmetric, because we know that if A is a square matrix, if A is a square matrix, A plus A transpose is symmetric, already we proved, and A minus A transpose is what? Skew symmetric, right? If A is a square matrix, A plus A transpose is symmetric, A minus A transpose is also symmetric, right? and divided by 2 if you take also symmetric, here divided by 2 also if you take also it is skew symmetric matrix, because we know that K A transpose equal to K into A transpose, and this is also symmetric and this is also skew symmetric. So that's why if you take this one A plus A transpose by 2 whole transpose, if you take 1 by 2 into A plus A transpose whole transpose, that is equal to 1 by 2 into A transpose plus A, that is equal to 1 by 2 into A plus A transpose, same getting or not. So that's why this is a symmetric and second one is skew symmetric matrix. How they ask the problem? Suppose they will ask the problem like this. If A equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, A equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 equal to P plus Q, A equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 equal to P plus Q, where P is a symmetric matrix and Q is skew symmetric matrix. P is a symmetric matrix and Q is skew symmetric matrix. Then find P. So how to find P? So this is P, this is Q. So simply you can write P plus Q. This is a square matrix. So P equal to A plus A transpose by 2 if you take, then you will get the P matrix, that is the symmetric. And Q asking Q equal to A minus A transpose by 2, based on this one examples also we are going to see. So this example also we can take. A you take plus A transpose divided by 2. A plus A transpose by 2 is a symmetric. And Q equal to, suppose Q symmetric, Q asking A minus A transpose by 2 you have to take. Suppose P asking A plus A transpose by 2 you have to take. Because this is symmetric, this is skew symmetric. Here they given P plus Q, where P is symmetric means nothing but this one only. Q is skew symmetric, nothing but this one only they given. Right? Clear? Right. Right, based on this I will give some problems, so you try to do that problems one by one. First problem, so only based on K set only I will give, not more than that. I won't cross NCERT syllabus and retained syllabus only, not a deleted syllabus. 1 2 3 into B equal to 3, 4 they given, then they asking order of the matrix B is, so options also I will give 3 by 1, second one 3 by 2 and third one 2 by 4 and fourth one 5 by 2. Right, just 5 to 10% logic will be there in, that's it. So here what they given, 1, 2, 3 means first row 3 columns, only 1 row 3 columns, but we have to find the B matrix order, right? So this is B matrix, we don't know that order. And here what they given, 3, 4 they given, right? First option what they given, 3 comma 1 and second option 3 comma 2. So only one row, two columns, right? But we know that if you multiply two matrices, number of columns of the first matrix P comma Q is there and M by N is there. Number of columns of the first matrix is equal to number of rows of the second matrix is there, means then only you can multiply that to two matrices, and after multiplication order of the matrix is what, this one you will get. So this is the rows, number of rows, and this is number of columns. So by that concept you have to find this one, right? Now here suppose you don't know this order, But this multiplication is defined. Multiplication is defined means definitely this columns of the number of columns of the first matrix is equal to number of rows of the second matrix. So that's why here this one should be 3 and here n. So you don't know n. But after multiplication, the resultant order should, order of the resultant matrix should be what? 1 by n. So 1 by n. But here already right side what they given? 1 by 2. Equality of two matrices, order should be same. So 1 1 n 2. So therefore n equal to 2, right? So what they given? N equal to 2 means if you substitute here 3 by 2, so B matrix order is what? 3 by 2. Clear? So here number of matrix multiplication is defined. So number of columns of the first matrix is equal to number of rows of the second matrix. So here 3 you have to take. This one you don't know. But after multiplication, resultant should be 1 by n. So 1 by n. But by equality of matrices, here what is the order is there? Here also same thing. So here 1 by n, here 1 by 2. So n equal to 2. So n equal to 2. If you substitute 3 by 2 is our required answer. Okay? Right. Next problem. Next one. Here one problem they given. If A equal to 0, 1 and 1, 0, then A power 5 asking. First option I, second option 0, third option A, fourth option A square. Yes, it means speed and accuracy important. So A power 5 asking. So technically you have to solve this one. First you solve, find A square. What is A square? 0, 1, 1, 0. So A square you can write A square equal to A into A. So 0, 1, 0 and 1, 0. If you multiply these two, first row with the first column 0, 0. Next, what will get? 0, 1 and, sorry, here 0, 1 and 1, 0 is there. First row with the first column 0 and here 1 is there. First row with the second column 0 is there. 0 and 0. And the second row with the first column 0 and second row with the second column. So it is nothing but identity matrix of order 2. So A square equal to I means A square whole to the power of 2. I will take I square. Can you write? So A square whole square means A to the power of 4. But I square nothing but what? I only. We know that I square, I cube, I to the power of 4 equal to I only. Identity matrix. But what is our requirement? A to the power of 5. So A to the power of 5 can be written as A to the power of 4 into A, that is equal to what? I into A. I into A nothing but what? A only. Right? So that's why. What is our answer? Okay. Like this you have to solve. Next problem. Next one. Here one more problem they given. R plus 4, 6, 3, R plus 3 equal to 5, R plus 2 and R plus 5, 4 whole transpose. Then if this one equal to, then they asking R value, R equal to what? Okay, so here this is also very simple. What we have to take R plus 4, 6, 3, R plus 3 equal to transpose of this one. So 5, R plus 5, this column becomes row and R plus 2, 4, right? Clear? And now equality, by equality of matrices, the corresponding elements here, order of this one and order of this one equal, and corresponding elements also equal, r plus 4 equal to 5, r equal to 1. So you can equate these two also, same thing you will get. Okay, so like this. Next, one more problem we will see. Right, next problem. Here, what they given? If if 3a plus 4b transpose equal to 7 minus 10 70 and 0 6 31 and 2b minus 3a transpose equal to minus 1 18 4 minus 6 minus 5 minus 7. Then they asking B matrix. 3a plus 4b b transpose equal to minus 7 minus 11 17 0 6 31 and 2b minus 3a transpose equal to minus 1 18 4 minus 6 and minus 5 minus 7. Then B asking how to do this problem. So this is also one of the important problem. So carefully have to do. B asking here directly B only there. But here what is there? B transpose is there. So that's why what we have to take? Taking transpose on both the sides. So 3A plus 4B transpose whole transpose equal to 7 minus 10 17 0 6 31 whole transpose if you take. So here by the properties of a transpose, what we have to take? 3a whole transpose means 3a transpose, and 4b transpose means 4b transpose whole transpose means like this. 4b transpose whole transpose means 4b transpose whole transpose, that equal to 4b. Okay, that is equal to, if you take the transpose of this one, so 7 0 minus 10 6 and 17 31 like this. Okay, and now after that this one you take. So what is there? 2b minus 3a transpose means like this. I will take minus 3a transpose plus 2b transpose plus 2b, right? This one minus 3a and plus 2b I am writing equal to right side. What is there? Minus 1 18 and 4 minus 6 next minus 5 minus 7, right? So take this as equation number 1 and this as equation number 2. Add these two, 1 plus 2. If add these two, this one and this one get cancelled. 4b plus 2b equal to what you will get? That is 6b you will get, that is equal to. So we have to add the these two matrices. Means what is the order of this matrix? 3 rows, 2 columns. Here also 3 rows, 2 columns means you can add corresponding elements. 7 minus 1, 6 you will get here. And 0 plus 18, 18 you will get. And minus 10 plus 4, minus 6. And carefully minus plus you have to observe. And 6 minus 6 means here 0 you will get. So 17 minus 5, 12. And anyway plus minus wrong means total answer going to wrong. So that option also will be there mostly. So 13 minus 7, that is 24. So B equal to what we had to write? 1 by 6 into 6, 18 minus 6, 0, 12, 24. That is equal to. So this is the scalar multiplication of the matrix. So multiply 6 into 1 by 6, 1 you will get. 18 into 1 by 6, 3. And minus 6 into 6, minus 1. 0 into 1 by 6, 0. And 12 into 1 by 6, 2. And 24 into 1 by 6 is 4. So this is our final answer. So that is, check the answer. So answer is 1, 3, minus 1, 0, 2, 4. So like this we have to solve. Okay, no? In the next video, some more problems we will take, so based on matrices, and after that exemplar problems also, objective problems in exemplar problem exemplar book. After that, the previous questions 2020, 2019, how they given problems on matrices, we will see. Okay, no? Right, thank you.